How's it going, everyone? College Lefty, and in this video, we have all of the Stage 2 team affinities that have been revealed so far. We'll also include some ranked gameplay, so let's go ahead and get into it. The Twitter for the MLB The Show account has confirmed that this Stage 2 team affinity, or Season 2 team affinity, will consist of legends and future stars. So the first one revealed was 93 overall Johnny Damon for the Royals, and honestly, I did have a list of legends included with some of the future stars, but I didn't talk about them in the video. I also had Johnny Damon as a Red Sox player, but he actually got a card with the Royals in this one, and a pretty decent selection. He's always had a decent swing. He'll probably be one of the lower overalls in terms of Stage 2, because we see some 94s, we see some 95 overalls, and this is a little bit higher than what I was expecting, but also, that's a good thing in the sense that we are able to parallel these cards up to like a 97, 98 overall, potentially some of them even reaching that 99 overall threshold. But I think that this Johnny Bench could be very good as a catcher, right, for the Reds. There will be one for each team, so keep that in mind, right? It says NL Central, but there will be one for each team within this pack. It's going to be similar to Stage 1, but I don't think you're actually going to have to complete Stage 1 in order to unlock these cards, which is also good. I'm looking at the tweet online right now, and it says here from May 22nd that you can earn these cards by doing team-specific missions releasing this Friday. I would assume that there would be some showdown involved with that. If you haven't checked out my How to Complete the Final Showdown Boss every single time by skipping to the end, then I would certainly check that out. I am going to be providing a couple videos on the showdown mode within Season 2 as well, as long as it's included, of course. But I wouldn't think you'd be able to unlock all of these higher overall diamonds just by doing missions. I think that there's going to be more to it than that. But there might be a mission for each one. I know that will provide at least a little bit of progress towards these players. But Willie Mays, 94 overall Willie Mays. We also got a glimpse at Lou Gehrig. I think this is amazing. This is something that I was looking for, and I mentioned this last year. Obviously, I don't think I had any influence in that, but I think the community in general has been wanting to be able to unlock mid-90s overall endgame legends. So what I mean by that is, right, we see a 95 overall Lou Gehrig. I'm really looking for this type of thing. 94 overall to 96 overall, players like Mickey Mantle, players like Willie Mays, Ken Griffey Jr. Not necessarily the best version of their card, but definitely a usable version at least until we get those end game players. But here we have Brandon Webb, brand new legend, and this is something that I was kind of thinking about, right? This player is not listed in the legends or on the legend teams as of right now within the game. Now, they might be able to add some of these players as we move on later throughout the year, but this is kind of what I was thinking, right? There's not a lot of legends listed on those legend teams. We could see some of these players added to that list, like Brandon Webb. Mark Pryor is listed as a legend, but here he gets a 95 overall card. Certainly a good card that should be able to parallel at least to a 98, if not a 99 overall tier. But we do have the first future star card also revealed, and I was incorrect with my prediction. Of course, we're 0 for the century right now, but it's all good. We have Jordan Groshans, and this card looks amazing. I mean, he's a shortstop. The Blue Jays got a little bit snubbed last year in terms of their team affinity card, so this is awesome to see. The only thing that's kind of interesting is that this guy also plays the same position as Bo Bichette. So with that said, you know, you can use him in a secondary position. He will have gold defense in the secondary once you parallel him up a little bit. But definitely a good card all around. Solid hitter, solid contact, good power. I mean, at this stage in the game cycle, that's a great shortstop to have. I'm sure there's going to be some other really good players that are revealed, but that's what we have so far that are revealed. We'll go ahead and get into some ranked seasons gameplay. I've been in a little bit of a slump. There'll be one game where I'll come out swinging, score a lot of runs, and then I'll just, you know, be late on every single pitch. A lot of times where I've been late on inside pitches, I've gotten rewarded on a few of them. But nonetheless, my timing has not been on point as it was earlier on in the game cycle. And it's also, you know, I'm going up against better opponents. I'm playing against better players in general. The game's been out for a little bit, so people are used to playing on Hall of Fame and everything. But Nonetheless, I've just gone into a little bit of a mini slump. Some games, you know, I'll put up a lot of runs early on, like we have in this one so far. But honestly, this is just one big inning, if that makes sense. I've been just inconsistent. I'll get shut out for a game, come back, put up, you know, 10 runs in the next one. It's just interesting. Here we get rewarded on a very late swing. I usually pull that pitch consistently, like I'm able to sit low and inside, react to the pitch up and in, but that just hasn't been the case. I have also been receiving the blue screen error message again. I know I put out a tweet I was talking about in my last video that some of this stuff was fixed. I was able to play a few games in a row, but we are still kind of receiving that blue screen error message. I don't know what is going on. I have tried many things. I think I really just have to try to get a new console in general, and that's my only option. So I am looking into doing some of that. It's not like I can just go out and get one. A lot of the stuff is overpriced and non-available because of what's going on in the world. So I will try to get one as soon as possible. But with that said, here we get a mercy rule. So we are able to get at least one win here, and we'll hop into another one. I just started off all right in this one, got a run on a couple late swings, stole some bases and manufactured a run. But that's really been why I've been losing a couple of these games, are just not hitting as well, just not hitting with runners in scoring position. Here we get another quit, so there's another win. But yeah, just a few games lately in ranked I've been slumping, and it hasn't been for a while, it's just been for a couple days. But here in this game specifically, I have like 7 or 8 hits and no runs right now in the bottom of the sixth inning, and that's just not ideal. I've left so many guys stranded. Here we're going to get an opportunity, and I'm trying to be aggressive, right, trying to take this extra base here, get into scoring position, and avoid the double play. I'm using the buttons to maneuver my base runners, and apparently I was sending Chipper Jones to third. I am almost positive I pressed triangle, but whatever, it's all good. With that said, it is definitely my fault for just trying to do too much in that situation. I would have been able to take the lead. This guy only had a couple hits in this game, but I definitely beat myself, and this is not me making excuses. This is just me analyzing the footage. I have done this for several years in MLB The Show, where these opponents are good. They deserve to win these games, especially when I'm doing things that are hurting me in terms of like beating myself in this game. I'm like going up against the opponent, and I'm also frustrated with how my experience has been with this game. Like, I don't know if I'm going to make it into the ninth inning. I don't know if I'm going to be able to finish the game or not. Sometimes I'm just thinking, you know, what should I do in order to try to score right now, just in case I'm not able to finish. But with that said, you know, it's just stuff that I have to keep in mind. Stuff that I'm trying to make adjustments, trying to break out of the slump a little bit. But at the same time, you know, these guys are good players. These opponents I'm playing are good players. They're robbing home runs. I have yet to do that. Most of the time when I give up a home run, I don't even have the opportunity to rob it. They just blast it out of the stadium. The ball doesn't even land. And I'm saying all this stuff with a smile on my face. But with this said, you know, this is probably the best swing I had this entire game. We made it into the ninth inning. I'm just happy with that I was able to finish the game. I honestly swung at every single pitch in this one. I'm pretty sure I swung at literally every single ball as well, and then took some strikes. I just have not been able to see the ball out of the pitcher's hand and react as well. I've been slightly off. But I'm also trying to, you know, have as much fun with the game in general. The way I've experienced, you know, the blue screen error, just my game crashing over and over again, has really just changed the way I look at playing video games in general, right? I'm just trying to have fun. This is an escape from reality for me, and I'm playing a video game that's baseball related. I used to play baseball like every single day of my life, so it fills that void for me, and that's really all I look to get out of this type of game. I just want to play some baseball, sit down, have a good time. And no, I'm not a robot. I'm not going to be able to hit and consistently play well every single time. I've been inconsistent since I started playing this game, but I also know that a lot of people are going through some of the slumps and going through some of this as what I'm talking about. But nonetheless, I am extremely excited for the brand new content that we have coming out in this game. I think this game is great. I have a lot of fun playing it. Of course, it's not perfect, right? There are going to be situations that happen that's out of your control. But I really feel like if my PlayStation was playing correctly, that I would be having the most fun with any baseball game that I've ever played. It's just the fact that I can't finish these games, it bothers me. Sometimes I make it to the ninth inning, like in this one. Right here, we hit a home run with Mike Trout, ended up getting out with Chipper Jones. We go into the top of the ninth, and I just blue screened a couple outs away from winning that one. Like, I won't be able to make World Series with this happening, but at the same time, like, I just want to play. But I also like to win. So it's kind of contradicting, I know that, but this has also never happened to me before. Anyway, I'm College Lefty. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.